things up and force out game number five. They are seeing a whole different team right now out of Edouard-Montpetit.
And the big thing for Northeastern is make sure the kickoff, if you can't win it, at least goes in a neutral fashion. Flums. A little fadeaway touch from the midfield line is turned aside by who else but Kromski. Transition back for Hero Darkness, and Eno will steal it away into the corner. And here come the Huskies storming back the other way. It's going to be a little bit of an awkward one to deal with. And that's actually a lovely touch from Hero Darkness. Everyone expecting him to catch that on a dribble, go across the net. Just throws everybody a loop, but a wide open net, and that will be turned in by Mercurial. One missed touch, and they are justly punished.
Yeah, you said it. Missed touch there from Hero Darkness, and Kromski thought he had it, so he goes for boost instead to prepare to push up the field. But the big miss from Hero Darkness lets Mercurial come through, and the Huskies find the first goal.
One thing Flam said before this matchup is, like, you know, we have a system, but we also have some plan Bs, some adjustments to make after game number three. I definitely think it was time to see that. Here it is. They go up one.
And Eno really could have put the pressure on with a second goal right there off another kickoff. Flom's dodging a demo. He's got Eno 2-on-1. I wanted to see if he went for the fake Chalion. Lovely challenge angle he took on that ball. All it would have taken was a flip in either direction. He could have done anything, and he just read Flom's like a book there on that defensive play.
So now Northeastern trying to keep the pressure on and go back to that comfortable play style that we've seen in the last few games. Not able to do it here as some misses come out from midfield, and Edouard-Montpetit now on the attack.
Flom's in a bit of a weird spot. Mercurial buys him a few precious moments to get his wheels back under him, and Hero Darkness tied up in the midfield. And Eno and I believe it's Mercurial tied each other up. Flom's is racing back, has to get this read, and the Huskies escape disaster and a free equalizer. And again, a communication sometimes tying things up for the Huskies could come back to haunt them.
Now Flom's not able to get that touch there. And for Edouard-Montpetit, that's a great play actually from Hero Darkness, but immediately saved away from Eno. This ball going both sides very quickly here as the transition
mechanical
for both teams. Chilion trying to put this one out the back wall.
And he flubs
it. But Flom's puts it away to the corner. And Edouard-Montpetit are not under immediate pressure. But as soon as I say it, Mercurial slams one home. And Northeastern are up by two.
Yeah, I don't think Flom's was expecting to actually get the demo there. So he just flipped to try and demo him. But he was already through the guy and then kicked the ball into the corner. Mercurial just fast on the read, able to get there first. And a nice turn in to make the lead two. But gotta clean it up if you're Northeastern and hang on to this game four.
I'll take shots I wish I got back for 800, Alex. You just know if CGM manages to lose the series, moments like that when the net is absolutely open and the opportunity's there, and you're not able to capitalize, Mercurial.
That's a great positioning coming out from Mercurial, and Flom's doing a lot of the work, putting this one across, beating Hero Darkness, and then Chilion, you could see a little crept up a little bit too far there. Mercurial's done a great job of staying central on the play and just waiting for the ball to drop off the backboard into the box, and he's just been poaching it every single time, and that's a point, or that's a goal that definitely highlights it.
Edouard-Montpetit, they need to somehow stabilize, recalibrate. It seems like they're frazzled right now. They just have to get back on the same page.
Well, Mercurial in command on a dribble. Kromski steals that one off his hood, but the follow-up, a little bit sluggish for Edouard-Montpetit. And they really got a press right here as Flom's has a free shot towards the net. An easy save, however, for Hero Darkness, but you need to see that coordinated offensive push. It kind of came out of nowhere for Edouard-Montpetit post-kickoff. In game three, come back if you feel like they want to have a chance. Because it's that follow-up game that's been the biggest weakness, as this is a free chance for Mercurial. They tie up two people off another touch to the back wall, and Northeastern's been picking on it all series long.
Yeah, they forced the double commit, and again, who else but Mercurial just sitting in the box, waiting for it to come down centrally right in front of his face, and he's just got to throw it on target. Now a four-goal lead opens up for Northeastern.
For a team that says communication is our strongest thing, you got to wonder if they're starting to get tilted with some of these gimme goals that are happening. We've seen them play better than this. Kromski helps get them back into the game. Explosive offense, that's how you do it.
He's the man you want to be taking the shots for Edouard-Montpetit, as Hero Darkness does a great job to push that ball on. And placement from Kromski into the corner. Fantastic shot from him. And the comeback is on with a minute and 51 seconds for the Lynx.
Kickoff will seemingly go the way of Northeastern. A couple of bumps, though. And Eno just waits his turn and is willing to give up possession with a three-goal lead. And it will become the boom the ball up the field and don't give anything away for free for the Huskies, as you imagine the end of this game should go. And it will just be Mercurial keeping pressure on as long as they can. And good communication there, because Mercurial has definitely been cutting rotation a couple times to stick with a few balls, and it's cost Northeastern a few goals throughout the series, so good to see that get ironed out, at least in that situation. And really, that communication in those instances would be one of the biggest things for Northeastern to clean up going into game five.
Yeah, and so now a minute left for Edouard-Montpetit to make the comeback, of course, down by three goals. Absolutely doable here, but they've got to score. Northeastern doing a great job of locking on. That one might slip in for Eno, and it does. Northeastern extend the lead to four.
That will definitely be the end here. Kromski not even making a bad play, just not able to get the car under it. Didn't have the boost to really stick with that ball. Could only tip it forward. And that's just Northeastern applying pressure and not letting them out for free if they've got the ability to do so, and that one happens to go into the back.
Northeastern, they're not letting up at all. They're like a three-point lead. No thanks. We're much better off at four, if you don't mind.
And the last time they had this situation was pretty much game number two, but they accomplished it maybe 2 minutes earlier. And it will be a slow, steady cruise to the end of the game here. And it will be Edouard-Montpetit just trying to get a few strikes on offense going, as Flams will turn another one in. And it's really just picking on that back wall, still hammering away. As Kromski, he tried, but Eno already advantage of position, has everything in front of him. Much easier play for him to make.
And you said it, and we'll keep saying it. For Edouard-Montpetit, it's mostly about just keeping that back wall clean. You can't let these balls go off the back wall and bounce, especially centrally, because Mercurial and Eno in particular have been very
right
good
on
about being right on top of them. And of course, the shooting from Flams has come through for the Huskies here late in this series. But that's really the biggest thing I could say about the Lynx right now, is just finding a way to make sure that there's someone up to contest those balls coming off the back wall.
Eno wants one more for measure and will not find it. So the final four to tick down. Edouard-Montpetit looking to improve the defense in game number five. Northeastern looking to keep the rotations in order and stop the kickoff game as well. So we'll see what's in store for game five. But the second game in this series, a convincing win for the Huskies.
CGM just needs to work on their consistency. As easy as they're able to find themselves, it seems like they